Three Dantians. Understanding the ancient Chinese concept of the three Dantians in the body is not a simple task. Generally, the entire brain is considered to be the upper Dantian. We know that the brain and the spinal cord are considered to be the central nervous system, in which the electrical conductivity is highest in our body. If we examine the brain's structure, we can see that it's segregated by membranes into separate portions. It is reasonable to assume that these materials are a tissue of low electrical conductivity. If the good conductors have been sandwiched by poor conductive material, then this system is able to store some electricity. However, we should also know that the brain does not produce qi, but consumes a great amount of it. Each brain cell consumes at least 12 times more oxygen than other cells in the body. Since in the biochemical reaction, oxygen is proportional to the production of qi energy in the body, it's reasonable to assume that each brain cell also consumes at least 12 times more qi than regular cells. The middle dantian, zhong dantian, is located at the lower section of the sternum, which is connected to the diaphragm. We know that the diaphragm is a membranous muscular partition separating the abdominal and the thoracic cavities. It functions in respiration and is a good electrically conductive material. On the top and bottom of the diaphragm there are the fascia, which isolate the internal organs from the diaphragm. We see once again a good electrical conductor isolated by a poor electrical conductor. That means that it is capable of storing electricity, or qi. The front abdominal area is located on the path of the conception vessel, so that whenever qi is built up to a higher energy state through movement of the abdomen, it will circulate in the conception and governing vessels. Fat is a material which has been filtered by the liver and has a very high content of calories. Therefore, it can be converted into qi efficiently. If you look at the structure of the abdominal area, you will see that there are about 6 layers of muscle and fascia sandwiching each other in this area. In fact, what you actually see is a sandwich of muscles and fat accumulated in the fascia layers. When you move your abdomen up and down in abdominal breathing, you are actually using your mind to move the muscles, not the fat. Whenever there is a muscular contraction and relaxation, the fat slowly turns into bioelectricity. Fat and fascia are poor electrical conductors, while the muscles are relatively good electrical conductors. When these good and poor electrical materials are sandwiched together, they act like a battery. This is why, through up and down abdominal movements, the energy can be stored temporarily and warmth generated. The real lower dantian is at the center of the abdominal area, at the physical center of gravity, located in the large and small intestines. If we look at the physical center of gravity, we can see that the entire area is occupied by the large and small intestines. The first thing you notice is that the total length of your large and small intestines is approximately 6 times your body's height. With such long electrically conductive tissues sandwiched between all of the mesenteries, water, and linings, which it's reasonable to believe are poor electrical conductive tissues, the intestines act like a huge battery in our body. From this, you can see that it makes sense both logically and scientifically that the center of gravity is the battery in our body. Modern science has recently reported that the human body has 2 brains. One brain is in the head, and the other is in the digestive system, known commonly as the enteric nervous system. Though these 2 brains are separated physically, through the connection of the spinal cord, which is highly electrically conductive tissue, they actually function as one. The upper brain is able to think and has memory. It is able to store data, utilizing electrochemical charges. The lower brain has memory, but does not have the capability of thought. This discovery offers confirmation of the ancient Chinese belief that the real lower dantian, or large and small intestines, is able to store qi, while the upper dantian, the brain, governs thinking and directs the qi. In other words, the lower brain is the human battery in which the life force resides. Once the brain has generated an idea or intention, thereby creating electromotive force, the charge will immediately be directed from the lower brain through the spinal cord and nervous system to the desired area in order to activate the physical body for function. We are starting to link ancient experience together with modern scientific understanding. Cell replacement. In order to produce healthy cells, you must also consider energy. You should understand that when a person ages quickly, often it is not because he or she is malnourished, but instead is due to the weakening of their qi storage and circulation. Without an abundant supply of qi, bioelectricity, qi circulation will not be regulated efficiently, and therefore your life force will weaken and the physical body will degenerate. In order to have abundant qi storage, you must practice qigong in order to build up the qi in your eight vessels, and also to lead the qi circulating in your body. The next thing you should ask yourself is how this replacement process is carried out. The entire replacement process depends on the blood cells. From Western medicine, we know that a blood cell is the carrier of water, oxygen, and nutrients to everywhere in the body through the blood circulatory network. From arteries and capillaries, the components for new cells are brought to every tiny place in the body. The old cells then absorb everything required from the bloodstream and divide to produce new cells. The dead cells are brought back through veins to the lungs. Through respiration, the dead cell materials are expelled as carbon dioxide. However, there is something missing from the last process. This is the qi or bioelectricity that is required for the biochemical process of cell division. It has been proven that every blood cell is actually like a dipole or a small battery, which is able to store bioelectricity and also to release it. This means that each blood cell is actually a carrier of qi. In Chinese medicine, it is said the blood and the qi are always together. Cell replacement actually happens from inside of the body, moving outward. If we are tense, the blood circulation will be more stagnant and cell replacement will be slower. Most cell replacement occurs in the night when we are at our most relaxed state during sleep. If we accept that blood cells are the carriers of everything which is required for cell replacement, then we must also consider the healthy condition of our blood cells. If you have good health and a sufficient quantity of blood cells, then the nutrients and qi can be carried to every part of the body efficiently. You will be healthy. However, if you do not have sufficient blood cells, or the quality of the cells is poor, then the entire cell replacement process will be stagnant. Naturally, you will degenerate swiftly. According to modern medical science, blood cells also have a lifespan. When the old ones die, new ones must be produced from the bone marrow. Bone marrow is the major blood factory. After a person reaches 30, the marrow near the ends of the bone cavity turns yellow. This indicates that fat has accumulated there. It also means that red blood cells are no longer being produced in the yellowed area. Chinese Qigong practitioners believe that the degeneration of the bone marrow is due to insufficient qi supply. Bone marrow washing Qigong was developed for this reason. From experience, we know that through bone marrow washing Qigong practice, health can be improved and life can be extended significantly. If you are interested in this subject, please read Qigong, The Secret of Youth, published by YMAA. Hormones act as a catalyst in the body. When the hormone levels are high, we are more energized and cell replacement can happen faster and more smoothly. When hormone production diminishes, then the cell replacement will be slow and we will age quickly. It was only in recent decades that scientists discovered that by increasing the hormone levels in the body, we may be able to extend our life significantly. Maintenance of hormone production in a healthy manner has also been a major concern in Chinese Qigong practice. According to Chinese medicine, glands that produce hormones were recognized since ancient times. Hormones were not understood. However, through thousands of years of practice and experience, the ancients understood that the essence of life is stored in the kidneys. Today, we know that this essence is actually the hormones produced from the adrenal glands on the top of the kidneys. The ancient Chinese also believed that through stimulation of the testicles and ovaries, the life force could be increased. Testicles and ovaries are considered external kidneys in Chinese Qigong and medical societies. In addition, from still meditation practice, they learned how to lead the qi to the brain and raise up the spirit of vitality. It has also been found that through practice, bioelectricity can be led to the pituitary.